Well, look out, Australia. Our favourite brothers are back and they're touring the country with their brand new album.
Hanson burst onto the American music scene in 1997 and quickly made a name for themselves worldwide with their Grammy-nominated hit, MMMBop. The song reached number one in at least 12 countries, including Australia, the United Kingdom, and the United States. Since then, Hanson has released 11 studio albums and have sold over 16 million records around the world. Now, in celebration of 30 years performing together, brothers Isaac, Taylor, and Zach have returned to Australia and will tour the country with singles from their fresh new album, Red, Green, Blue.
Can we get a little commotion for Hanson? Welcome.
Thanks for having us.
It is so unbelievable to have you here in the studio, and we managed to peel off all our staff members who were mobbing you earlier. Emmeline, Gemma and Brittany made me promise not to embarrass them on television by mentioning their names.
There's a few people
so
you're going to have to let go.
guys are actually here to promote the fish missile.
I'm going to fish rocket right now.
You set it in the yard, you launch it, it lands in the ocean, it returns, it uses all this Elon Musk technology.
Hanson will be at a beach somewhere with a fish rocket and making some omelets.
You were invested. You were not taking your eyes off that. What's it feel like to be back in Australia? Because Australia loves you a lot.
We've always gotten a lot of love from the Aussie fans, and it feels great. I mean, we've, like so many bands, the last 2 years has been very quiet, and the whole world it was.
We're making up for it, and with 101 shows in 21 countries this year.
Wow. Well, you were on stage last night.
Yeah.
Very un-rock and roll to be on morning television the next day.
No, that actually is rock and roll.
Is it?
Because people actually have to get up, which means you roll out and you kind of like...
Usually you're throwing television. It's not on television, you know?
Rock and roll is much more working class than people think.
Yeah.
You just show up and you make it happen. I mean, the thing about live music, honestly, is, like you said, it... is every night, you know?
Yeah.
And you have to get up and do the next thing, the next city. Yeah. But to have fans that want to come out, I mean, this year we've been a band for 30 years, and so to have fans that continue to come out year after year is amazing.
Just don't take for granted.
No, and Australian fans, of course, are a notch above
the best.
Absolutely. Not even joking.
What separates them from the riffraff in other countries?
They're more attractive.
The fish rocket, really.
There's a lot more fish. The most beautiful fans is the main thing, actually.
Just the best, most entertaining. Honestly, the experience here we feel very at home when we're here. People are very warm.
Yeah.
You guys have a little bit of an American rascally spirit. We like it. Yeah. You know, people like to have a good time.
Well, your fans have grown up with you as well, right? Sure. So. You're all grown up, Mav, got families of your own. Yeah. You've had your fans do that as well. Yeah. So what's it like now to have kind of the mums in the audience going a bit wild?
Mums Gone Wild is coming too. You know, it's honestly the same in the sense that it's about making music that people want to connect with. And when we were kids, we were hearing records that were from artists long before we ever showed up. Mm-hmm. Classic rock and roll and soul records. Yeah. And so we just feel like we're picking up the legacy of our heroes, because you look at an audience now and you see teenagers, you see people in their 30s, 40s, 50s.
You see little kids.
And music, I mean, that's what music does. It continues to people discover it at different points.
Yeah. And people are loving the new album, Red, Green, Blue, where we get a taste of sort of each of you individually as well.
Yeah, it's a very unique project. We did it in three parts. Each brother wrote and produced five songs. And so that's not something we've ever done before, but, you know, so you're at this point in your career where you're looking for new challenges and ways to invite people into new stories. And this just seemed like a really cool way to kind of talk about the DNA of what makes our band unique.
Yeah, so true.
And after working for 30 years together and being brothers, of course, was it nice to kind of branch out as well? Is this a bit of audition piece? Are you wrong?
I was really looking forward to being like, Zach, go away. Leave me alone.
We don't think of it as much as being about separating, but it is true. It does put the spotlight on each brother.
Yeah.
And I think there are important challenges I think that everybody probably has they need to do, you know, but this is really more, I think, about saying, hey, Isaac, I support you, or Taylor, I support you, and really kind of giving that moment to each other.
Gosh, you're nice
now,
boys.
Aren't they lovely?
So
and,
nice.
And can I testify that they always have been? Now, believe it or not, I interviewed the three of you back in 1997.
Oh.
You want to have a look?
Oh, my.
Here we go.
Absolutely.
Ike wrote his first song when he was in about third grade.
Yeah.
And it kind of, we started doing the same thing, Zach and I. And then we just started harmonizing together. But that was, I mean, we didn't really start performing until about 6 years ago. We did our first performance. It was at an arts festival in Tulsa.
And then after 3 years of doing a cappella, then we got instruments, drums, guitar, and keyboard, you know, because we wanted to accompany ourselves.
We'd like to defer to our younger selves to tell you the history.
I mean, nothing changes. Nothing changes, and it is really funny to look over there, and I see us. But I can also see our children. You know,
that's like, very interesting.
What would you tell those boys now?
Man. Invest in Apple.
Actually, I think we did a pretty good job.
Bitcoin is a good thought. Just go ahead and jump in early. You know.
I don't know. I mean, I think we've stayed true to ourselves as much as I think most people can. And I think, you know, for lack of better say, well, you know, we're a little weirder than you might think, but we're still relatively sane along the way.
I think one of the things that's interesting that, you know, people are so infatuated with fame and celebrity. The minute someone succeeds, they just want to talk about the fact that they're famous. And really, that's always been boring to us. Like, we're here because we're musicians, because we wrote songs, because we have something we want to throw into the world and put into the world. And so I think it's just fascinating now because we were saying the same things then. People were fascinated that we were young. You know, and then they're fascinated that we maybe thought that we were girls. Or we were Australian.
Taylor, stop telling them that we're boring. They'll find out all on their own.
No, but all those things, I just think it's, you know, it's always been about the music. I mean, that's really what it's about. It's about making the next project.
Yeah. Oh, we want to steal you over the commercial break. Can you
hang on?
Hang around for 3 minutes. All right, we're talking to Hanson live in the studio. You're watching Studio 10. Don't go anywhere. More to come.